everyone. In this video, we're going to look at a multi-body example from the help palette, and we're going to use this to explore the parameter sweep and optimization apps. So this example called throwing a ball is a system with an arm that rotates around at a constant speed and then at some specified angle releases the ball, which then hits the ground and sticks the landing. So we can see our up and down as it moves in the circle, then gets released, travels along the X direction and sticks to the ground. Now, of course, if we release the ball slightly earlier, it's going to come a little bit closer. And if we release it later, it's going to hit the ground much sooner. So, of course, we want to find the optimal angle that will give us the furthest distance that we can throw this ball. I'm going to save the results as original just so that we can compare it to our final optimized release angle later on. And this release angle is in the parameter block under the name ANG. So we see it has a 360 for one full revolution, and then an extra 220, which is the current release angle. So first we'll begin by performing a parameter sweep where we can vary the value of this angle and see how it affects the results. So we'll go under the model analysis and we'll double click on parameter sweep. We're going to load our system. So again, connecting the app to our model, bringing all that information in. We're going to pick the angle parameter and add it as a part of our simulation. Number of data points, I'm going to increase this to 100. I want to see a lot of results. Outputs, there's one probe, which is the X displacement. We want that. And we'll get the time series and we'll get the max. So we're going to run our parameter sweep. And what I really like about this is how you can see it really goes through those 100 simulations very quickly. We spend a bit of time compiling and optimizing the model once, and then can very quickly pass those different values for those parameters. So just like that, we have the results for 100 simulations. Here we can see the plot envelope, so kind of max and min as we move along in time. I can see individual results. Or, because I've selected the max option, I can choose this as my data to plot and choose my angle. So we can clearly see from here that if my angle is smaller, I'm not, you know, traveling as far, and there's going to be a maximum, an optimal point, and at which point if I go beyond, I start, you know, not traveling quite as far. So we'll see that we'll call it between 10 and 10.75, and this is the range we're going to use in the next app, the optimization app. So I go back to MapleSim, and I'm going to select the optimization. Again, I'm just connecting to the same model, but now I have a better idea of what range I want. If I had just gone directly to this, I might not know which range I want it to work in. But now I can select that angle, and I'm going to set the tolerance small just because I want to be able to take full control of the min and max. So 10 was my lower bound, and we had said that 10.75 would be my upper bound. So great, this is the only parameter I'm interested in. Now I can go to my objective function. So it's automatically selected, it's the X position. I'm going to give it full weight, so we'll set that to 1. I don't need the absolute value. I'm interested in the last point, and I want to maximize my distance. So with everything set, I click on the run parameter optimization, and it's going to tell me how many simulations it's performing, it's going to tell me the objective function, and eventually it converges and finds a solution. So here it's telling me the optimal value for my objective function, not the release angle. For the release angle, I need to scroll down to the results section, and I can see that the blue curve is my current value, my nominal value, and the green is my optimal. So I can actually do better than what's currently in the model, and that's by using 10.34 radians. I can update the parameters in the MapleSim model with the click of a button, and if I go to my parameter block, I see it's already updated. So if I were to subtract the initial 360 for that, you know, one turn, this is a release angle of 232 degrees. I can run a simulation with this optimized value, and I'll see compared to my previous results that I am indeed throwing the ball further. And this is how you can use the Parameter Sweep app as well as the optimization app to investigate your model and really enhance the performance of your system. Here we see the current results going further than the original.